Now there might be a situation, guys, in real time, what happens is your manager might come and tell you that, hey, you know what, you ran that command in that server and because of that, our business is impacted. Now in this kind of situation, it is a challenge for you and also for your manager to identify who actually ran the command. In this case, Putty has an option where you can log all your Putty sessions into the text files. Now with this option, what happens is if your manager is coming and saying that, hey, you know what, you ran this command, you can actually open the logged or the saved sessions from your Windows machine and show him that you did not run the command. So this way it becomes a transparent case. You don't fall into the trap of blaming in an IT industry. In this Putty, you can see we have this logging option, right? So this logging option will allow you to log all your Putty terminal, everything, like whatever you see on Putty, it will be logged onto a TXT file. So you just need to use this option. Now, once again, I want that by default, every session should be logged in. Okay, that is my requirement. So what I will do is I'll first make sure that it is on the default profile. That means nothing is there in the host name, nothing is there in the saved sessions. So this is now the default profile. So while you are in the default profile, click on logging and then choose this option, all session output. I want everything, everything that is seen or every output that comes in the Putty session that must be logged onto a new file as it is. Okay. Now next is you need to give the log file location. So what I would do is I would choose a folder. I would try to create a new folder under E drive. You can create it anywhere, wherever you want. And I would name it as Putty underscore log. Okay. And just click on save. Now this is not enough. It is actually creating a file called as putty.log. The problem if you keep this file name as putty.log is there will be only one file which will be overwritten again and again. So you won't have any history Putty sessions, right? So we need to define a unique file name for every time that you connect to a server. Now if you read this part, log file names can contain ampersand y, ampersand m, and ampersand d for date, and ampersand t for time, ampersand h for the host name, and ampersand p for the port number. So what I would actually choose is, I would say like the host name, ampersand h, that means which server I connected, and then underscore, I would give the date, that will be ampersand y, ampersand m, and ampersand d, then again underscore, ampersand t, because t is very important so that we have uniquely defined timestamp for every host where you connect. Okay, and then you can just type dot txt. This will actually create a notepad txt file for your Putty sessions. And then what you need to do is go back to sessions, click on default setting and click on save. So what is the benefit now? Let us try to connect to a server 49.207.1.90 and then port number in my case is 167. I will open this one. Let us log in as root user. Root at the rate, okay. Now I'm into the server. Let me try to issue some commands, then I'll close the Putty session. And then we'll verify whether we are getting the Putty log perfectly or not. So ls-lrt ps-ef grep root, okay. And I'll just do an exit. Okay, now what we can do is we can actually navigate the file explorer, go to the E drive, get inside the Putty log, and now you can see this my Putty log session. This is the server 49.207.1.90 which I connected. This is the date 2017, 9th month and 19th date, and this is the current time. I mean, as per my system, it is 10:44, it's almost same, 10:43:35. Let us open this one, and then you can see everything is logged in, right from the login to the server to the entire output that you had on your Putty terminal. Don't worry, sometimes you might see some special characters and you can just ignore them, but this option comes very handy when you want to refer your history logs, when you want to refer some output from a different terminal, when somebody is blaming you that you ran a wrong command in a server, and also many a times you use this one for reference purposes. Now, this is a very important feature, guys. If you are working as a system admin or an Oracle DBA, I believe you must always keep this Putty logging enabled. Now, let us look at another example. Like, this is for the server one, right? Let me try to connect to a different server, and then we will see whether our logging is working perfectly fine or not. I'm connecting to 166. Now, can you see, as I connected to the server, immediately another Putty log has been created. So whatever you type in this one, it will be added to this log file. Okay, so ps-efcrip root, and I'll exit. Now let us check this latest file that is generated. Can you see? It also has all the commands which I just now ran, ps-efcrip root. So I have all the output. This will save you a lot of times in case of crisis or in case of problem. So make sure whenever you're working in real time, the Putty logging is enabled.